was Bellevue to the East, and it was a dream come true. It was amazing. On the record, I did, or before Beauty and the Beast, I did On the Record, which was a tour. Never went to Broadway. It was basically a review of all of Disney's music, and I got that pretty much right out of college, which shocked me as much as it did everybody else.
After R, you do that. R. So let's try that again from S. All
right.
S.
Frankly, quite upset to leave through lengthy lexicons to find the perfect word. A little spontaneity keeps conversation king. You need to find a way to say precisely what you mean. Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious, even though the sound of it is something quite atrocious. If you say it loud enough, you'll always sound precocious. Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
But it doesn't mean anything.
It can mean exactly what you want it to. When Stone Age men were chatting, simply granting would suffice.
Now if they'd heard this word, they might have used it once or twice.
I'm sure Egyptian pharaohs would have grasped it in a jiff. Then every single pyramid would bear this hieroglyph. Oh, supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. Say it, and while animals will not seem so ferocious, add some further flourishes, it's so rococococious.
Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
The druids could have carved it on their mighty monoliths.
The ancient Greeks, I'm certain, would have used it in their midst. I'm sure the Roman Empire only entered the abyss because those Latin scholars never had a word like this.
Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
If you say it softly, the effect can be hypnotious.
Check your breath before you speak in case it's halitosis.
Oh, word.
Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
Which is so cordially of exisiligarfilly creepers.
She may be tricky, but she's bloody good.
So when the cat has got your tongue, there's no need for dismay. Just summon up this word and then you've got a lot to say.
Pick out those 18 consonants and 16 vowels as well, and put them in an order which is very hard to spell.
S-U-P-E-R-C-A-L-I-F-R-A-G-I-L-I-S-T-I-C-E-X-P-I-A-L-I-D-O-C-I-O-U-S.
Clever cloaks.
Where you move your arms. Don't to feel like you can't move, but I think to pick those special moments, like when you're in the beginning, you're just like, look at this stuff. You know, it's like you are just surrounded and your world is so big. And I feel like to make, when you use your arms, to make it very, very specific. So when you move your arms, I believe you.
Anything to just have fun. And as soon as I started
so burnt out, I would go hang out with my friends. And I tried to find a happy balance, but I think just always realize there's a future and there's more. And just to always tell yourself that. And that you can do it. I mean, nobody really paved the way for me. I mean, I didn't know. I just went with my heart and I knew what I wanted. And it can happen. No matter where you're from, what you do, what your parents do, you work hard enough.